Hello students, last class we have discussed about the exercise 3.3 we have discussed and we have discussed up to question number 3. Today we'll be discussing from the question number 4, 5 and 6 we'll be discussing it today. So let us go through the first question, that is question number 4. Let us go through the board. So the first question is, the performance of students in first term and second term is given. Draw a double bar graph using appropriate scale and answer the following. We have to draw a double bar graph. Double bar graph, what does it represent? Double bar graph, we have to draw the graph in this way. Okay, this is your double bar graph. So you can see for the English subject, Hindi subject, Math, Science, Social Science, two values are given there, you see. For first term and for the second term. That means when you draw the double bar graph, one bar graph will be for the first term, the second bar graph will be for the second term. Now, in which subject has a child improved his performance the most? But for that, you draw the graph first. English is 67-70, so you can see the graph it is being drawn here. English, Hindi, Math, Science and Social Science. Okay, the values are given here. Again, the value is started from 60. The zigzag line is there. The zigzag line is represented there. The lower values are not there. So we are not using that values. Now, first of all, it is representing 67 and 70. Now you can see one box. How many scales is representing? You see, it is 10, 10, 10, 10. It is going on 10, 10. That means one line represents 1 inch or 1 centimeter or the number of marks. Okay, now the first time for the English, he has scored 67. 67 if I draw, this is 60, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So this line will be representing a 67. Next it will be representing 70. 70 will be represented, this is 70, so 70 will be somewhere here. This is a 70. So if I draw a bar graph, so this is how we have to draw the bar graph. This is your graph, 67 and 70. Okay, first term, second term. Go to the next one. Hindi 72, next is 65. Hindi 72. So this is 71-2. That means this is representing 72. This is 72. Next we have 72, then we have 65. So 60, the middle line will be a 65. So this will be a 65. So this is 65. Okay, so this is for the Hindi. Next we go to the Maths. Maths here we have 88 and 95. So Maths, this is 80, 85, 86, 87, 88. So it will be somewhere here. This will be 88. Next we have 95, this is 90, so this will be 95. This is for the Maths. We go to the next one, 81 and 85. So this is 81 for the subject Science. This is 81 and we have 85, so this is 85. Next we have 73 and 75 for the Social Science. This is 70, so 1, 2, 3. So this will be 70, 1, 2, 3. 73 will be somewhere here. This is 73 and we have 75. Sorry, this will be not 75, sorry. Okay, so we have drawn the bar graph. So you have to draw this graph on a graph paper. Don't try to draw on your copy. This have to draw on a graph paper. So the next part, what is given? In which subject has a child improved his performance the most? That means we have to compare the first term and the second term. Which student has improved the most? See the bar graph. Which one has improved the most? this if you consider 60 and 70, only 3 differences there. This is going below. This 88 to 95 it has improved. This is 81 to 85 it has improved by 4. This is only improved by 2. This will be also. This as you can see 88 to 95 it has improved by 7. That means for the first answer, this will be your in max. In which subject is the improvement the list? Improvement the list. Here it is 3, social science. This answer will be social science. Because it has improved only by 2. Has the performance gone down in any subject? Has the performance gone down in any subject? Yes. Hindi has been gone down. 72 to 65. The answer is Hindi. So this is for the problem number 4. So let us now discuss the next question, that is question number 5. So let us move to question number 5. Question number 5. Consider data collected from a survey of a colony. Favorite sport, cricket, basketball, swimming, hockey, athletics is given. Watching and participating, it is given there. We have to draw a double bar graph. So this is a graph, it is being drawn. So the cricket, basketball, swimming, hockey sport, athletics is there. Then we have on the y-axis, you have to take the values. You see which one is the highest value here. Highest value is 1240 and the lowest value is representing by the value 105. So that is the lowest value. So we have to draw the graph. Here the values are taken in a 300, 600, 900, 1200, 1500. You can start from 100 also. Okay, you can start from 100. Here it is shown as a 300. You can start the graph from 100 also. So the first one for the cricket. 1240 and 620. 1240 and 620. This is 1200. So this will be. So this is 1200, 1500. So this will be.
Watching and the drum.
1200 and between 1500. So this will be representing around 1300 some points will be representing. Okay, 1240. 1240 will be somewhere near to this. Okay, 1240 will be somewhere near to this. This will be representing a 1240. Then we have 620. 620, somewhere it will be here. Okay, then we have for the basketball. Okay, first of all, let me write this. Okay, so for the basketball, if I do this is 470 and 320, the 470 will be somewhere, this is 300, so it will be somewhere near here. This is 470, and then we have the 320. 320, so this is 300, it will be somewhere here. So in this way, you have to draw the bar graph. This is I am giving you as a homework. You have to draw the bar graph by using this scale also. You can take 100 as a scale also. Most proper you take 100 as a scale because this 300 scale is becoming too big distance. Okay, you take the scale as a 100, 100, 200, 300, doing that way. Then draw double bar graph choosing appropriate scale. You have to draw that. Which sport is most popular? So if you see here, which sport is most popular here? Cricket is the most popular sport. Which is more preferred, watching or participating in sports? Preferred, watching or participating in sports? Watching is 1240 and participating is, it is given the other numbers, let me check once. One question was there that what do you infer from the bar graph? This was left out. We infer from the bar graph that if you see the numbers, the number of watching is more than that of the participating, you can see. That means more number of is preferred watching than they're participating. Okay, so we have to write, for any sport, more persons are interested in watching than participating. For the second part of the answer, Okay, this is our conclusion. Then if I go for the next part, there is question number. So question number 3, which is more preferred watching or participating in sports? You can see from the bar graph, which we have already discussed in the first one, that the people, they are more interested in watching them in participating. So the third one, which is more preferred, watching or participating, your answer will be watching. This will be your answer. So this is what we are planning, problem number 5. So in the next class, we'll be discussing the other questions. So please draw the homework, that is the first part of the double bar graph. You have to draw in that way. You can see the graph is also showing here. This is how will your graph look like. Okay, but you have to draw the bar graph in your notebook. So this much for today. We'll be doing the next topic in the next class. Thank you.